Hi, future sixth grade students and parents of sixth grade students. We are so excited to meet you in person. We don't really know what it's going to look like next year yet, but we did want to share with you some information about what the school year looks like for sixth graders and give you a sense of what to expect as you transition to the middle school.
First things first, congratulations. Graduating from elementary school is a huge deal, and we are so happy to get to be the ones to welcome you to the next big chapter in your life at school. As I'm sure you know, there's a lot that's new about middle school. You'll be changing classes, you'll have more subjects, and you'll have a bunch of teachers where before you just had a few. Plus, in the sixth grade, all of the elementary schools in Ashland come together for the first time to join a larger community. Sure, you'll see your friends, but you'll also meet kids from all the other schools, which means more friends, more diversity, and fresh new ideas and interests. Does it sound scary? Don't worry. You're ready. And on top of that, we got you. We're going to take it nice and slow, and we're going to be with you every step of the way. So here's the deal. Your schedule at AMS looks something like this. You'll have full days, Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday, with an early release day on Wednesday.
You do move from classroom to classroom as a sixth grader, but it's going to feel the same each day. And don't worry, you will learn your way around in no time. Your schedule will look something like this, with homeroom first, and then a class called INC, which stands for Individual Needs Class. Then you'll have two core classes before lunch, one core class after lunch, and then a PCAT class. PCAT stands for Physical, Cultural, Art, and Technology. Those classes include things like PE and Health, Band and Orchestra, Video Production, and Art. At AMS, we have teams. In the sixth grade, there are two teams, Siskiyous and Cascades. And no matter which team you're on, you'll have four amazingly funny, smart, adventurous, and really wacky teachers. Let's meet some of them.
All right. My name is Jeff Multanen, and I'm the sixth grade math teacher. And something interesting about me is that in 2013, I did an activity to get me in the Guinness Book of World Records, but I'm not going to tell you what that activity is yet. You have to wait.
All right. And my name is Beth Ayler, and I teach science and social studies in the sixth grade team because I'm super duper fantastic. I get to teach two subjects. And something interesting about me, right now I have 9 cats living in my house. And there is an octopus that usually lives in my classroom. I've taken him home for the summer. But you'll have to look for him when you come into my classroom next year.
And my name is Carl Pryor. I'm the librarian at Ashland Middle School, but I also get to be a homeroom teacher on the Cascades team. And one thing that I think that maybe a lot of people don't know, but all these folks on the team know, is that I've run the Boston Marathon 3 times, including the year that the Boston Marathon bombing happened. Fortunately, I was already finished.
Nice. So my name is Wendy Wertheiser, and I teach language arts on the Cascade team. And something that is kind of interesting is I was able to compete in the Parapan American Games, but like Jeff, I'm not going to tell you what that was in. You'll have to figure that out for yourself.
All right. Hi, everybody. My name is Hillary Cosenza. You can call me Miss Cosenza, and I will be your science and social studies teacher on the Siskiyou team. And one unusual thing about me is that I am left-handed.
Hi, everyone. I'm Allison Hutchins. You can call me Mrs. Hutchins, and I am the reading specialist on Siskiyou team, and I also work with Cascade students. One unusual thing about me is that I have a pet rabbit named Blueberry who I like to snuggle with.
My name is Martha Street, and you can call me Miss Street, and I'm the language arts teacher on the Siskiyou team. And one interesting thing about me is that I love doing headstands and cartwheels in the grass outside our building with you, with sixth grade students.
Hey everybody, I'm Brittany Hardy. You can call me Mrs. Hardy. I will be teaching you math on the SISQ team, so get ready. It'll be a really good time. And one unusual thing about me is that I used to teach special education in Australia. So we're really looking forward to meeting you all.
It's going
to
be awesome. Mm-hmm.
See you soon.
Bye.
If you've driven past Ashland Middle School any time in the last year, you've probably noticed that there's some pretty big changes happening around campus, and it's true. In fact, at the end of last year, we tore down our old sixth grade building and are building an entirely new facility to house our future sixth graders. What does that mean for you? Well, it means two things. One, you are going to start your middle school career in what we now call Portable Village. But that also means that in the course of the next year, you are going to get to see a whole new building being built right before your very eyes.
Hi, I'm Allison, and I'm the Child Development Specialist here at Ashland Middle School. I want to tell you a little bit about our philosophy to student behavior and discipline. At Ashland Middle School, all of our staff work really hard to make sure students know what is expected of them and how they can be successful here at school. We understand, though, that sometimes students might make a choice that is unsafe, unkind, or just not a responsible choice. As the Child Development Specialist, I get to work with students when they've made a choice that maybe isn't their best choice. We work together to help them understand why their choice wasn't a great choice, and we make a plan so that they can make a better choice in the future. We understand that all of our students are still learning and growing and learning how to be their best selves and make the best choices that they can. We truly believe that challenging behaviors and mistakes are just another learning opportunity. And I'm really excited to be able to be here and help students learn and grow and navigate the challenges that they might face in their middle school years.
Here at AMS, we understand how important it is to keep parents in the loop every step of the way. To that end, we have a variety of tools we use to communicate with parents on a regular basis. The first of those is Office 365 and Canvas, your gateway to your students' daily classroom activities. If you're interested in grades, the Student Achievement Snapshot and PowerSchool provide up-to-date information about how your student is doing, missing assignments, incomplete assignments, things of that nature. Our quarterly newsletter, Mail from the Middle, gives the wide scope of events coming your way throughout the course of the school year, while your Friday e-newsletter, Update from the Middle, keeps you appraised of weekly upcoming events. We also, of course, have the AMS website, which serves equally as a portal to all your other online tools, our AMS Facebook page, and of course, the tried and true emails and phone calls.
Because we want AMS students to get the most out of the learning that they can while they're here on campus, we have very clear expectations about cell phones and personal device use at school. From the first start of the school day bell to the end of the school day bell, cell phones need to be turned off and away. Staff should not see them or hear them. And this includes at lunch and during passing periods. During those times, we want students to practice their face-to-face social skills.
Parents, we know this is a time that many families might open the door to cell phones and social media for their students. We recommend that families wait until eighth grade to do this. Whether you've opened this door or not, we want to encourage you to take a very active approach in supervising your students with any social media or cell phone use. Some families are surprised at what students are doing and seeing online. And often, unfortunately, they don't know about any of this until after the fact. If your student is on social media, please supervise their use regularly and monitor for appropriate language and behaviors.
You are really lucky to be going to AMS where there are so many awesome extracurricular activities like theater, science bowl, chess club, brain bowl, Oregon Battle of the Books, math counts, homework club, the State of the Jefferson scavenger hunt. If you enjoy cooking, you might join the culinary club. If you enjoy running, or even if you don't know you enjoy running yet, you might join cross country or track. We also have student unions here, which are a pretty awesome way to find community at school. We have a Black Student Union, Native American Student Union, Asian Student Union, Latinx Student Union, as well as a Queer Straight Alliance. Registration will be happening over the summer. Watch for an email that will be coming home from Ashland School District at the beginning of July. Registration is all online. And get ready because school starts before Labor Day again this year.
Let's do this!
Beautiful game, and together at the end of the day.